So you guys have heard about Dr. Fosi Kong talking about how to find bugs from deep learning programs, and I will then talk about how to figure out what goes wrong, figure out the root causes of these bugs. So these days, AI, artificial intelligence, has been increasingly embedded into modern software applications and the systems. And the key enabler behind this is deep learning. And you know, deep learning is quite different from traditional software engineering. In traditional software development, we programmers manually write the program logic in source code, right? But in deep learning, the models actually learn their own logic from the training data. And also, in traditional software development, everything is encoded in symbolic representations, right? Data structures, et cetera. But in deep learning, things are encoded into high-dimensional arrays, and there is a lot of calculus and linear algebra operations over these arrays to make the inference. This brings a lot of challenge to debug deep learning models. You know, in the old world, traditional software, if we want to debug an error, we basically set a breakpoint, and we can step through each line of code to figure out the root cause of this error. But in deep learning, for a neural net, how do we even set a breakpoint? Even if sometimes we can actually peek into the internal, you know, a specific layer or neuron in the neural net, but what we can get from at the runtime values we get from this neural net are high-dimensional arrays, which are hard to interpret, right? All right, let's actually look at one example. Suppose you're a programmer and you actually trained this recurrent neural network to classify Reddit comments to positive or negative opinions. And you find out the model accuracy is pretty low and you are wondering why, right? So for example, this comment clearly shares a negative opinion, but the model misclassifies it as positive. So it's really hard to tell exactly what happens inside the model, right? And why this error occurs. And this is actually why some people, you know, actually call deep learning alchemy, right? People don't know exactly why something works and why something doesn't work, okay? It's like a giant black box to us, to programmers. Our solution is to transform this complex and familiar neural network back to something we are familiar with, right? Like a finite state machine. And in this way, we can bring back all the good stuff we have in the traditional programming world, like people can step through each state in the finite state machine and inspect the state value in the finite state machine. So based on this idea, we actually built a debugging tool called DeepSeer. In the middle of this interface is a visualization of the finite state machine abstracted from an RNN model. And it provides programmers a bird's eye view of what's really going on in the internal decision-making process of the model. And the model reads each word in input text. It will transit between different states until it reaches to the end of the text to make the final decision. And if you click on state, you can actually see the frequent words and phrases associated with this state. So in this way, we convert those uninterpretable high-dimensional arrays into a symbolic representation that are interpretable to programmers. And you can also dig into individual data points in the training data, search and filter, and trace all the way back to the state diagram. Going back to the previous misclassification example, with DeepSeer, you can actually enter this misclassified text into DeepSeer, and DeepSeer will immediately produce a state trace that reflects the intermediate decisions made by the RNN model after reading each word in the input text. Here, red means negative and blue means positive. Similar to how you step through a program, the source code, you can step through this state trace and look at what happens after, you know, the model reads each word in the input text. And we can see that, you know, this RNN model actually changes its mind several times when it's reading the input text. And in particular, after, you know, read this word quarters at the end of the sentence, the model suddenly changes its mind from negative to positive, right? And never changes it back. So it actually provides us some good hints for further debugging, further investigation. When we actually search this keyword quarters in the training data, right? We can see that the data is quite imbalanced. There are 28 sentences mentioned this quarter, and 27 of them are labeled as positive. Only one of them are labeled as negative. So that means the model actually learns a superficial correlation between this word quarters and a positive opinion, right? So this is very likely to be the root cause of this misclassification. To further confirm the usefulness of this idea, we actually did a user study with 28 CS students and asked them to debug two different models trained on two different data sets using DeepSeer versus another popular debugging, deep learning debugging tool called LIME. And we found that students using DeepSeer provided more reasonable insights about the root causes, and they also found more error-inducing keywords in the input sentence compared with using LIME. So, key takeaways. You know, I think given the opaqueness of deep learning, I think it's quite important for us programmers to understand what we are building and be responsible for the model errors. And to achieve this goal, we actually need to build new debugging tools that account for the unique characteristics of deep learning and to make these tools usable to the broad population of programmers. We need to transform the internals of a deep learning model into something that we are familiar with, that are interpretable to programmers, rather than something that only makes sense to machine learning experts and machine learning theorists. Finally, I want to give a shout out to my collaborators at the University of Alberta, and thank you all for listening.